So basically, when you look at it, that's a 4 and 5 inch work line. Right through there. Take it as high as you like, there's 14 stacks on the back. Now when you go in. Smells like beer.
I'm sorry. I had a drink before I.
Or Katie smashed 3 bottles of beer in the car.
You thought she had started.
No, she didn't. Now when you're here, 10 and longer. So basically what you're aiming for is you're drawing everything to the center of the beam. So this becomes your focal point, it's there. On the nape, like I said, you do your own thing. Now, when you go there, watch the top of the cones, you'll get a visual answer to what you're asking. There. Then when she's in, find your line, how clean you want to run it, and then you're in.
So you've got a nice demonstration.
Yes. Now, when you come there, I start turning the beam in. Now, I'll bring it in. How I do my nape? I weaken them before I put shape on them. Oh. And just come in. Then when you're there, let the top part still compress the cone there. And if you could grab my razor from there, please. Now I'm really coarse there. That's that there. That's in the middle. Your right hand on. Yep. Is when you're there, just you see all the serrations that are on there? Mm-hmm. Just knock them off. Just knock them off. Yeah. Don't focus on the neck, just as they're watching for them. And there it goes. Then you push them in. Now remember what we said, 6 and 3, push them away. They don't belong in the design. You're going to work on that central back only. If you think you can do this with 2 fingers, let me be the bearer of that now. We've spent thousands of hours as teams working on this. Now, my way of doing napes is just working from underneath and then head. You do your own.
May I ask why you work from underneath?
Yes, because I can get it flat to the head of my work.
Even if there's cowlicks?
Even if there's cowlicks.
Thank you.
But when you do that, make sure that when you are, that you're running the blade quite steep. Because a lot of the cuts now are sort of semi-stacked. What I mean by that, they're not big stacks under, they're semi-stacked. So your focal point right now, if I just push this in, you can see the light on it. Now, when you do this, don't go too short in a minute. Let them sit and see how they fit. So when you turn to the mirror, bring this out. Here's the mirror. Always look at what a client looks like. Then when you bring this in your hand, there's your scene. Yeah. Always run to what the beam would do. There you can see the beam. Now this is what I mean about when you and I said 6 and 3. Look, you've left these completely out of the equation. All you're looking for is a soft contour. I mean, you can go high stack, low stack, Jackie O, whatever you like. All I'm looking for, look in the mirror, is that. Just a gentle look, gentle stack, but sit. Then I'll lock this symmetry in here. Now, where's my girl? Remember I told you about pendulums?
Mm-hmm.
This is how you lock them. Now, I know this is a lot to take in, but you want to be the cats around town? It ain't a gift, and it doesn't come from nothing. You've got to practice it and work it. But you've got to know what you're doing, guys. This is just a shitty old mannequin that you're just showing a technique on, but you master this, you're going to a league of your own. Now when you go around, now walk, come to the right, because you're going to push this low stack forward. Now I'll go over here, see right what you're doing. Now, if you don't get full control on it, what you're going to do is, because this is just one number one line worldwide for color treated, we went into an oil category thinking we wouldn't get anywhere. We won number one oil, which pissed a lot of people off. This and the true curl. So this is where I cut it. This is the can't find the symmetry, because there's no weight or color to it, push this in. Push it into your cup, it'll start sliding. Push it in. Now, with all the designs, my directors do this as the hardest thing they find. As long as they can. Because normally you would do this, you just take it over here. You push the lines in. Now, if I stop right now, where are your heads at?
You stop right?
If I stop now and say, start, you start, where's your heads at?
Where do I start?
Yeah. That's always my question. Well, my sons and I are jamming on concepts and ideas. I know that they're working on very advanced stuff, the two of them, because they're extremely advanced colors. And I'll say, where did you start? And they go, why do you always want to know where to start? They're into the cut. And I go, if you don't teach me how what your mind's doing to start, like the shortcut, I hope you get through the day, but I doubt it, is understanding your frame. You've got to frame everything. Now, normally, does this look familiar? I do this. Right?
Yeah.
Every time I look at you, come here a second. Let me see the bottom one.
Oh my God.
That must have hurt.
Yeah.
They all did? Weirdo. So, push this in. And bring it forward. Now, watch. Very gently, drop the cone under, which is the cone of reference. This is the cone of compression. Then you turn it in. So you start a bend 45 from the back. You guys got it? So when you do it, look, guideline, guideline. This is the cone of reference, this is the cone of compression. Have you got it?
There is space between the cones.
Minimal. Minimal space. What is happening? You need to get your shit together and understand what's about to hit you on the website. Give me my cones. Both of them. Now, when you hit it in, you're lucky you got that right. You'd have definitely been asked what if you hadn't done that. Under. So this becomes where you want the design to go. This is just the fabric compression on the top. Not there. Last night this was the problem. They go, no, this just means you will cut. This. Right. You'll cut reverse stack graduation. Mm-hmm. You've got to cut it to where this is what's going on. So the underneath is reference, the top is compression. And it's the most all this is it just changed everything I've done. And I was with students for decades, but this changed everything. Because I realized there was an art form that was far more relaxed. Now, point to my two reference points. Let me drop them down. Can you see them?
Mm-hmm.
Look, there they are. See it? They've got to join together, but you can't cut that straight across. Because it will just sit there. It's got to be in motion. Short hair does what to long?
Pushes it.
So when you go in, now, look where the left cone is, high. So then you turn it, look, you see where it is now? Then, from there, move forward.
May I ask why you have that space between the cones?
You've got to see what your frame is. You can't see it, compressed cone. Now push it, but don't touch anything yet. You've got to change your mindset on how these cuts work. So when you fold it, It's a round swing. Let it sit. Don't touch it. Then go back up in front. Look, the blade was my thumb. Look, this is the only operating blade. Mm-hmm. This is thumb. So when you go in, pull the tungsten back and put the frame in. Then drop on top. It's literally the thousands of hours of mindset I had to go through. The way I was trained was pull it, cut it, lift it, layer it. And all of a sudden, I'm not touching it. It changed everything for me. And when I started doing this, That's when I got asked to do all the Italian shows, which is very rare. Now when you look in the mirror, look, there she is. You're looking round, look. Could you see how round it is there?
Yeah.
Look, so this is the weight that will move it forward. And it will, look, there's your arc. Look in the mirror, look, there it is. That's what you're looking for. That's reverse symmetry, is your light being there. Then sit it. Then come to this side. Now this is where I've got to get you this morning. You've got to get to where I'm here. Now remember, reference, and compression. Now watch as you turn. Where's my arm? Come on, how about it? Don't miss it. So look, guidelines. Now, with the pure release.